you like?
Your servant,
Maji Atiku Abubakar, Waziri Adamawara. He has made himself the sacrificial lamb to rescue this country. Lord, you chose him. Bless him, give him wisdom, and most importantly, give him good health.
Amen.
Father, use him as an instrument of redemption of this country.
Amen.
Your people are crying. Your people have been oppressed. Democracy has been thrown out of the window. But today we are happy. We say thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Because you've chosen somebody that will bring us out of the world.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, the form that we presented to him today, bless it.
Amen.
Bless it.
Amen.
Bless it.
Amen.
So that from today onward, Nigeria will be happy.
Amen.
That you have sent your own son, your own servant, to bring this country and make this country great again. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Your Excellency, let's get Nigeria walking again.
Say Atiku!
Say Atiku!
Let's get Nigeria walking again!
Let me plead with you that we're coming to the very serious part of this program. Let us be quiet, please. Thank you. As I invite the former governor of Ogun State, the Director General of the Atiku Presidential Campaign Organization, His Excellency, Engineer Otumba Justus Olukenga Daniel, to come and give his welcome address.
Fupati.
Your Excellency.
Fupati.
The podium is for the Minister of Justice. Your Excellency. By the special grace of God, the incoming President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Haji Atiku Abubakar, Grand Commander of the Order of the Niger. The Waziri of Adamawa, you are most welcome, sir, to this event. Of course, His Excellency is not here alone. We have a coterie of leaders and leaders of this great country who have come to support in this very important program. I won't waste your time with protocol, but of course, on this table, we have Alhaji Yaya Abubakar. We have the former Minister for External Affairs, Chief Dube Mumia.
Let's make Nigeria working again!
Say Atiku!
Let's make Nigeria working again!
Say Atiku!
Say Atiku!
Let's make Nigeria working again!
We have also the former Minister for Niger Delta, and our office will be also here.
Rescue Nigeria! Rescue Nigeria!
Say Atiku! Rescue Nigeria!
Of course, so many other leaders and elders are here, but because this place is very small, what we have just done here is a Wazopian representation of this item, if you have noticed. Because from the perspective of His Excellency, he is at home everywhere in this country, and that's what we are seeing here today. Your Excellency, let me also say to you, sir, that whereas this large number of people have whispered to me what they have come here to do today, but I will not speak for them. They will speak for themselves. But let me also assure you, sir, Your Excellency, that the number of people who are outside are far more than the people inside. And I just want to seize this opportunity to thank all of you most sincerely, especially those people who have come from wide and near and they are not able to get it because of space. Your Excellency, these are the support groups across the length and breadth of our great country for the Atiku movement. And I must say to you, sir, that these are your most loyal supporters in all the length and breadth of this country. Your Excellency, let me also inform you, as you have led the nationwide consultation to all the length and breadth of Nigeria, in each and every location we have gone, we have been met by various colors of these organizations. And none of them have asked us for any compensation or any mobilization. They have shown great support from their limited resources. And when they come out here today, you will begin to see where they are coming from. Your Excellency, over the past few months, they have in to come and have a feel of you. Some of them just want to touch you, some want to take selfies, some just want to relate with you. And I'm happy that this is now happening today. Great supporters of Atiku, they are not asking me. Yes, you know the way this campaign is going. Everybody agree that our country is not working. Or is it working?
No!
So the theme of our campaign is, let's get Nigeria working
again.
Complex is the most sophisticated campaign organization machinery that you can find anywhere. And when the campaign proper starts, you will see the kind of networking that we'll be doing with you. What is important for us and for you is to stand firm, because we have come to a stage where we have no other choice but to take on this country and begin to let this country work again. Once again, I told you my job is limited today. I'm not about talking. You are most welcome as I now hand over to the people who have called on us to come and tell us why they have invited us here this morning. Thank you very much.
Okay, you want to know his slogan? Consider it done. When they say OGD, you say consider it done. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, the DG sir. The Excellency, when we saw them, we wondered what they wanted. But then, because they are your supporters, we have no alternative but to create an event for them. For if there is no you, there can be no them. And if there is no them, there can be no you, literally. Therefore, it is my responsibility to invite Dr. Nathi Aduma, the Special Advisor Support Group, to come and tell us precisely.
PDP. Let's get Nigeria working again.
Atiku.
Atiku.
Let's get Nigeria working again.
Your Excellency. Your Excellency, I'm surprised. And I'm very sure, Your Excellency, that you are also surprised. Because in all the campaigns we have done, Your Excellency, before, we have never, ever witnessed this kind of situation.
Oh, yeah.
Your Excellency, these are few leaders of over 200, over 2,000 groups that we have registered. They are all on our database, and they are working. Anywhere you go, Your Excellency, you will find support groups of yours who believe, who have passion for Nigeria, and who believe in you, that you can drive us to the current slot. Your Excellency, these are just leaders, few of them. When I came yesterday, Your Excellency, they told me that they are going to give you a surprise. They have not told me, just like the DG told us. And I came in here, Your Excellency, to tell you that this is just a bit of them. And they promised to work hard for you, to pray for you, until when we get the ticket of this party and win the election and take Nigeria to the promised land. Your Excellency, I would like to call my deputy, Ola Fabi, to introduce leaders, a few of the leaders of the young people who will tell us what they have for us, the things that were never witnessed, and let us hear them, and let us know why we're here. Ola Fabi, please.
Let's get Nigeria working again. Let's get Nigeria working again. Atiku! Say Atiku! Thank you very much. Your Excellency, the former Vice President of Nigeria, Wasim Adamawa, Atiku Abubakar, GCON, Your Excellency, the Director General of APCO, Supervisor Daniel, distinguished ladies and gentlemen at the upper table, our support groups, I stand here before you very humble. Let me thank Dr. Nat for inviting me to come and do this. Thank you very much, sir. Your Excellency, in putting all this together, I work with a team of 5 members who were so committed and they were selected across the country. I would therefore like to invite them one by one to say a few words. The first among them is from the northern part of Nigeria, is Princess Josephine Washman. Can you please give her a round of applause to be formed? I'm going to talk to her for just 3 minutes.
Thank you.
Let's get Nigeria walking again.
Our people.
PDP.
Our
Your Excellency, it's a great honor to be here today. Your Excellency, the DG of the Latin Presidential Campaign Organization. Your Excellencies, all the coordinators of the Latin Presidential Campaign Organization. Let me stand on existing protocols. Your Excellency, like Dr. Yeduma has said, this is the first time that the Atiku campaign organization will be witnessing a thing like this. And we felt that it was important because the time has come for Nigeria to be great again. So we felt it is important for the Nigerians to be the ones that will lead the process and go ahead to buy the ticket. And we put together, to buy the nomination form, and we put together a team that works to achieve that. Eventually, I'm sure Ola will do the rest by calling the rest of the team up here. But I'm part of the team, I'm from the North Central, and I'm representing that region on that team. And I want to say thank you for the campaign organization for also supporting us, giving us the space to do what we have to do, and for this event to be successful. Thank you very much.
Let me call on Engineer Dan Ohiomobad from the south-south part of Nigeria to please come out quickly. Please establish as your protocol has already been established, just go straight to the point. Thank you.
Let's get Nigeria working again! That's not loud enough. If we want to get Nigeria working again, we'll take it by force. So I repeat that. Let's get Nigeria working again!
Our people!
Our people! PDP! Power to the people! Your Excellency, I stand on the existing protocol. I need me to cry out. I'm highly humbled to stand before great men of this nation, our incoming president, members of the campaign organization, and a few members of the thousands of support groups that are here. What goes up for the support groups? Your Excellency, when we started this mission, we never expected the support group to give us this kind of audience. We got Nigerians involved, regardless of party affiliation, tribe, or religion. We came together and agreed that we are going to purchase the nomination form. Your Excellency, with the help of your team and your DD, they gave us a boost, encouraged us, and today, sir, we are here to tell you that Nigerians want you. Nigerians want a change. Nigerians want to move forward. Nigerians want to get Nigeria working again. By who?
By you.
Sir, I want to say Article 2019 is not about political party. It's about Article. PDP knows it's about Article. Article has the experience, he has the political maturity, he has all we need to get Nigeria working again. Let's make Nigeria working again! Atiku!
Thank you much, man. That is the leader of Waziri Frontier Network. Thank you very much. Let me call on Dominic Ozo Okechukwu, the leader of Atiku Leadership Democratic Initiative. Thank you. Too late.
Thank you very much. Let me still, Your Excellency, let me still stand on the existing protocol. I would like, please can we relax and listen to what I want to say right now. It's important for us to understand why we all have gathered here. We have gathered here because we want to have a better Nigeria. We have gathered here because we want a place that will be good for our children's children. We have gathered here because we have seen in a man who has the capacity to take Nigeria to the next level. I've been working hard with the full support group to see that a day like this will come.
happiness has started. Millions of Nigerians will wipe their tears because the man in question, Alhaji Atiku Abubakar, I will give my own support and I will stand with all to support him to see that at the end we will sing the glorious song. And the song shall be that Atiku Abubakar is the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria come May 29th next year. I will all urge all of our supporters to keep doing what you are doing. You guys have done so well. I travel around and I see you and I applaud you and you will continue to do. I want to say something. When I watched him speak in London in Chatham House, I knew we have a leader in him. He will take us back to where we belong in the community of nations. I want to urge each and every Nigerian listening to me, to that taxi driver in Aba, to that woman selling clothes in Lagos, to that person in Bauchi, down to Maiduguri, down to all the country. He is the unifying factor. He is married to the east, married from the west, come from the north. He will stand in the middle to bring all of us together to get Nigeria. This is what I'm saying today. Thank you very much. Say Atiku! Get Nigeria working again. I always say thank you for this single honor. I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Leader Dominic. Please call me. Let me call on Princess Kemi Ebonta Adesanya to please come forward.
PDP! PDP! Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Now, three people have spoken, but I have not heard you say why exactly you are here and why you have done to do what you are trying to do. So please, that is what I now want to hear, because I don't know why you are here.
Your Excellency, Alhaji Atiku Abubakar, GCON, former Vice President, Federal Republic of Nigeria, Waziri Adamawa, permit me, sir, to stand on the existing protocol. As we've been told, my name is Princess Kemi Adesanya Ebonta from the Southwest. And it's a rare privilege to stand before your esteemed self. On behalf of all the Atiku support group in all the 774 local government areas of 36 plus 1 states of the Federation and the diaspora.
Can we hear what they are saying?
Your Excellency, sir, we, the Atiku support group, we have come together, we have contributed our widow's might to purchase the PDP nomination for. Your Excellency, to challenge you to run for the office of President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria on the platform of PDP, because we know that you only can deliver Nigeria from the situation we are in right now. And for this reason, we have come together to purchase the form and to let you know the reason why we are doing this, because we have resolved that this form will stand as a covenant between the Nigerian people and your humble self. And the secondly, the struggle and the journey that lies ahead of you is no longer about you, but about the people of Nigeria. Your Excellency, that you must never take your eyes off what the job that lies ahead of you. The utmost goal is for you to be able to put in your best in the interest of Nigeria and the Nigerians. Your Excellency, we trust that come 2019, when you become the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, by the grace of Almighty Allah, we will operate an all-inclusive government. Your Excellency, you will create employment. Because the state of unemployment in this country is deplorable. And you will provide jobs and security to ameliorate the incessant killings in the land. And Your Excellency, you will restructure Nigeria. And bring back unity and sanity into the government. Your Excellency, I stand here as a woman, as a mother, and I speak the voice of millions of mothers in this country. Your Excellency, we are tired of what is going on. We crave your indulgence, and that is why we have put our money together as your support group. And we are charging you, Your Excellency, that when you get there, relieve us of all the pains and agonies. We are tired of sending our children to school without getting gainful employment. We are tired of insecurity, of my children getting killed every day. Your Excellency, sir. Your Excellency, finally, on behalf of all the Atiku support groups in Nigeria and in diaspora, we want to present the presidential nomination form of 10 million naira and the expression of interest form of 2 million naira to you, Your Excellency. And I want to say thank you all for lending me your ears. And I pray that as you journey along, the Almighty God will go ahead with you and you'll succeed in this mission. Thank you all and God bless.
Thank you. Let's get the Nigerian walking again. Atiku! Before you thank you very much, thank you very much. Your Excellency, part of those people who are your supporters and their clients, so many numbers, they have sent their representatives here to say one or two words before you, sir. I have the leader of the physically challenged girl in this country. She's here. Can someone please bring forward Ndidi Amaka Okwu to come and speak to the next Nigerian president and Nigeria for just 2 minutes?
Walking again.
I
good evening. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you.
BBB!
Wait now.
Thank you, everybody. My name is Midamaka Oku Joseph. I'm from South East. Atiku Abubakar is a very good president. He will be a very good president, sorry. I want someone like him to be a president in this Nigeria, to wipe the tears of the less privileged, the disabled people, even those who are crying in many countries, many states, especially the black people, those people that kill them every time I weep. 200 people is not 2 people. I want Atiku Abubakar to be the president of Nigeria in 2019. He's a very good man with good heart, a very kind man. He's a generous man, a man who doesn't support tribalism. He's a man who will take the Nigerian to the next level. He's a man who will clean the tears of every people, every state. In fact, I can't mention them crying, including I myself. Every day I've been weeping, no one to help us. The less privileged, the disabled people, no one to help us, no one to hear our cry. But I know that Atiku Abubakar will surely share our cry and weep our tears. And I say that God Almighty will help him to become the president of this Nigeria. Whether the devil like it or not, he will be the president of Nigeria. He will lead the tears of Nigeria. He will lead many people that have been crying, that have been killing, many innocent souls have been killing in this Nigeria. I want everybody, even I myself, I have my own PVC. And I will surely vote for Atiku Abubakar. And I'm telling all the Nigerians, everybody to go and vote for Atiku Abubakar for a good change, for a great and a peaceful nation to reign in this our country, Nigeria. Thank you very much, sir. I know you're a good president, and you surely be a president in this our country, Nigeria. You must occupy that seat while the devil like it or not. You will help us, you will help those of us who are disabled, those who are the less privileged, those who need your help, those who are crying, you will surely clean our tears. Thank you very much, sir. God bless you.
Thank you, Didi. The last person to be called before the presentation will be Elijah Sunny, the leader of the Salvation. Please, for 2 minutes. Thank you very much.
Atiku!
Let's get Nigeria working again!
Let's get Nigeria working again! Your Excellency, our incoming president, on Wednesday, 29th of May 2019, inshallah, will be our president. So, you know, I'm going to leave the house, so the call is for Chabu Naka for the most of the regard for the Pomiana. Kowa ya san dalilin da yasa shi da mai girma ya bar jam'iyyar APC ya dawo PDP. Wannan alƙawuran da suka ɗauka kamin su zama shugaban ƙasa sai daga baya aka zo aka canza alƙawarin. Ya ga shi ba zai iya tafi da su ba. Shi yasa ya bar jam'iyyar APC tun da farko don alƙawarin da suka saba. Shi kuma mun san shi da cika alƙawari. Ya zo da kuma duk wacece mu ya share mana hawayenmu. So ba tare da ɓata lokaci ba. Za mu gaya ma mu ƴan group ɗin nan gaba ɗaya wanda muka haɗa leaders na nan barin gyara ba shi DG da ya magana dazu ya ce supporters naka gaba da cewa it is some of the leaders da suka zo nan ba dukkan mu leaders ba muka zo. We have over more than 2,000 support groups in Nigeria that suke supporting naka amma alhamdulillah yanzu kakan na ayyukan mu da muke ma nan.
kuma mun siya ma wannan funding ne du ka zo ka kwatar mana hakkin mu akan wanda ba zai ba mu hakkin mu ba ba mu so wanda zai mana alƙawarin kariya already kai ka cika mana alƙawarin ka tun ba maka hauba Allah ya baka sa Allah ya ba mu nasara komai
PPP Atiku
Let's get Nigeria again
Thank you so much
Thank you very much now the time is here we would like to but before I do that I'd like to invite Adai Edwin Adai please Adai please come out he is the chairman of Atiku Presidential Nomination Fund Group we ran through this round together so with the presentation of this form I would like to invite all the speakers to please come up while Adai please bring it on come up let's move to the general board
to
lead us
hold down please don't block
to
Just like you've heard from the various speakers,
Madam, go there.
This are your support group. From all over the country. We have come together to show you that indeed Nigerians love you. In the course of reaching out to ensure that we purchase this nomination form, we also have the privilege to meet critical stakeholders in this country. Those who are in the same positions who will decide the fate of Nigeria in the 11th hour. And they assured us that indeed, that the PDP will do everything humanly possible to conduct free, fair, and credible primaries.
Who is that?
And if that is the situation, we can boldly say that by the grace of God, you will become the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria.
No, don't go up, please. Go down.
On behalf of all the support group,
bring it down now. You just front and
you see your we are presenting.
What is this?
360 now. On behalf of Nigerians and the entire support group. This is the People's Democratic Party electoral guideline for the primary election. This one is the expression of interest for the presidential primaries. And by the grace of God, in the name of Jesus who made this happen, we present to you. And in the name of Allah, we present to you on behalf of the entire Nigerians and the PDP, the Atiku support group, your nomination form.
This is my
Gentlemen, can you just step aside a bit so that the pictures can be taken? Thank you very much. Step back a bit. This is a time in history. This is a moment in history. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Shift my office camera. Hey, what? Please, Facebook Live.
Your Excellency.
And the check now, I'm black. This idea they play.
PDP.
Power to the people.
Let's get Nigeria working again.
Atiku.
Atiku.
Let's get Nigeria working again.
Thank you very much. I would like to appeal to the cameraman to please allow me have a view of the hall. Thank you very much. Please, may I have your attention? Please. Let me have your attention. I will not continue if I don't have your attention. Your Excellencies, leaders and members of the Atiku support group present here, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, it is almost three decades of my political career this year. But today has also turned out to be one of the most emotional days in in those 3 decades of my political career. I have tried to present myself as a candidate for the office of the president in a number of elections. The only time I succeeded on being on the ballot was in 2007. And in 2007, I was on the ballot not because I believed I was going to win, but because I wanted to prove a constitutional issue so that all Nigerians can avail themselves of that constitutional protection. I wanted to prove a constitutional and I succeeded issue at the Supreme Court.
So that all Nigerians,
and that is why today
can avail themselves,
no Nigerian
that constitutional
can be stopped.
I wanted to prove a constitutional
from contesting election
issue at the Supreme Court
unless he has been convicted by a court of law. The event today is significant, is historic, because this is the only time in my political career that the young men and women in this country have come together without my knowledge or even concept, contribute their own heart and money to buy me a nomination form and an expression of interest form. But as you could have seen, one of the people who spoke, the lady who spoke, this is the word now, virtually succeeded in getting me to win. This is because she aptly described the challenges every Nigerian is facing in this country today. And she believed honestly and sincerely from the bottom of her heart that I could be an instrument of addressing those challenges. And believe me, addressing those challenges are possible because we have got young men and women, Nigerians, who have got the talent, who have got the education, who have got the experience, who have got all what it takes to honestly turn this country around. But putting together such talented young Nigerians requires leadership. And it is that leadership we have not been fortunate enough to have on a consistent basis in this country, so that this country can take its rightful position in Africa and indeed the world. So for such a woman to be believe that I have got those leadership qualities, and including those of you who have brought out your monies to buy this form, is one of the most serious challenges I have ever faced in my political career. It is not that it is not doable. It is doable, and I think together we can do it.
Yes, we will.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to make an undertaking, and I hope we get that opportunity to work together so that this undertaking of mine can be achieved. Because I alone cannot achieve that undertaking. Just like you have gathered here together, it requires all hands on deck to turn around this country. The man actually who brought me into politics, the late Shehu Musa Rabwa, may his soul rest in peace. When he invited me as a young man, he told us, among others, because in every state he looked for a very, very promising young man like myself, and he recruited us. And he said to us, let us, in those days, break the regional siege that every part of this country has been subjected to by the then political leaders. He said, let us break the siege. Let us reach out to our fellow Nigerians across the Niger, east and west of Niger, and make sure we bring the people of this country together. To him and for him, that was a major objective. So when he died, and I decided to build the Yaradua Center in his memory, we got an architect to design an uncompleted bridge. So if you go to Yaradua Center now, you will see an uncompleted bridge. The significance of that bridge was that we had started building bridges of understanding and unity across this country. And unfortunately, the man who started building that bridge died. I wish I could complete building that bridge. Thank you very much. So, ladies and gentlemen, let me, on behalf of yourselves, the campaign organization, and of course, the political parties, because I don't believe there is any other aspirant who will have the privilege of what you have done to me today. You have come from different political parties, from different parts of this country, to be able to buy me this form, I believe most of you are unemployed. Because we have got the highest rate of unemployment in this country since independence. My prayers is that I hope this endeavor of ours will result to a success in the nomination and of course subsequently in the general elections, so that together we can work. The undertaking I'm going to give you is that it is our job together. And we are going, I promise you, we are going to do it together.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's get Nigeria working!
Thank you very much. So, ladies and gentlemen, let me once again extend to you my greatest appreciation for this gesture you have done to me. And I believe if you purchase the form, so you will also run around to make sure that I have been duly nominated from different parts of this country. So that when I go to submit the forms, I will again enjoy your company and support. And on that day, let us overwhelm the PDP secretariat. Let us bring Abuja to a standstill. I bet you by the time we overwhelm the PDP secretariat and bring Abuja to a standstill, the PDP will have no alternative than to give us the ticket.
Your Excellency, thank you very much for your extremely presidential response. Sometimes, Your Excellency, you never can tell what a man that is quiet can do until you give him an opportunity to speak to a few issues. I am sure the entire Nigeria has heard you. Right now, it is my duty to invite Dr. Sam Wanu to come and do the vote of thanks. Just before Dr. Sam, I am told, Your Excellency, that today is turning out to be a day of multiple presentations. One of the support groups has also told the DG that a presentation is about to be made. So I beg you to tarry a little bit while we have this presentation made. Can the presentation come forward now? Thank you.
Yes, I know.
It seems like a symbolic map of Nigeria. Oh, with Your Excellency right at the heart of it. And a mirror to see yourself every day when you wake up. That this country must be great, and you have a duty to achieve it with the help of everybody like you have asked. Thank you. Thank you. They turn it on. Who's doing the presentation? Alright. You tell us your name and do the presentation very quickly. Protocols have been established. Don't bother with that.
Say Atiku.
Let's get Nigeria working again.
Your Excellency, sir, on behalf of the Young Initiative Group of Nigeria, we are here to express our full support by this symbolic gesture, sir. If you may, sir, you may come to the front. You will notice that. Sorry. It expresses itself already. We see Our Excellency in the map of Nigeria. We see our presidency. Therefore, we know that His Excellency, by the grace of God, is coasting to victory. So I'd like, on behalf of all the youth, express our solidarity and support for His Excellency, our leader and mentor. And by the grace of God, we know that he's going places. I know he's going to liberate Nigeria from all the hardship. Your Excellency, sir, please accept our humble gift and hope that this pushes you forward into greatness. Thank you, sir. My name. My name is Sayonga Kaigama. I represent Youth Initiative Support of Nigeria. Thank you.
Your Excellency, because it's a Friday and we are mindful of going to the mosque, Dr. Sam Warren for the vote of thanks.
Let's get Nigeria working again. Let's get Nigeria working again. Atiku.
Your Excellency, Alhaji Atiku Abubakar, GCON, former Vice President, and by the grace of God, the next elected President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Your Excellency, Tumba Benga Daniel, the Director General of the Atiku Presidential Campaign Organization. Your Excellency, my task is simple, and that is to give thanks. I want to thank Almighty God that I, in particular, am a witness to this day. But above all, I want to thank God that He has given us a peaceful and a very, very inspiring event. When I volunteered to work for this campaign organization a few months ago,
I didn't know it was going to be such an emotional ride. To see my principal come to tears, just thinking about the challenges that, you know, we are posing to him today, has convinced me that the efforts of those of us who work in this campaign organization now looks a little bit insignificant to me. I now know that this is about you. It's about you, the Nigerian people. For you to put your money together and raise over 12 million naira to give to one of the richest men in our country is outstanding, just to say the least. And I want to thank you. May God bless you. May he replenish the pockets from where you found this money to present this form to our principal. I also want to thank Ayaja Tusabaka himself, because the humility with which he accepted this present is also remarkable and inspiring. He could have said no, because he has the money to buy the form. But again, like I said, it has now occurred to all of us that this is no longer about us. He has offered to lead, but he has also told all of us that it's only together that we can get this job done. He will be in front, and the rest of us will follow. I want to thank those of his friends, our leaders, our elders who have come to lend their support today. We appreciate all of you, jointly and individually. I want to thank the very, very many support groups. I know it's not been convenient admitting all of you. As head of security here, I want to apologize for all of our rudeness. But you know, sometimes security people are forced to be rude, just so that everybody will be safe. So I thank all of you for coming. I commit you to the care of Almighty God. And please, please, I beg you, remember what the principal said. Go out there and get everybody to support what we are doing, and hopefully we will see all of you on the day we return the form. Let's get Nigeria working again.
Atiku!
Atiku!
Let's get Nigeria working again.
Thank you all very much. May the good Lord bless you all. Thank you. National anthem. Arise, go come. Thank you.